Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed the basic terms of the solutions. So let us see what is solutions. Solutions is a binary component of the Generally here state of solution, physical state of solution we are taking, that is gas, liquid, 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 solid, 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 and also again gas and gas. Okay, now state of solvent and state of solute means if you take gas, what will be the solvent and what will be the solute? Let us see here. So here gas, okay, the solvent will be a gas and also solute will be a gas. So example, what we have taken? Air. For example, in the air generally if you keep a smoke, then what happens? The gas is releasing. Okay, let us take that gas is a solvent, a solute, and in the atmosphere already the gases are present like oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, that all. So that one will be the solvent. Okay, so gas and gas. And coming to liquid here, the solvent will be liquid, solute will be gas. For example, oxygen in water, and also you can take soda. Okay, drinks. Some of the drinks, if you have been taken when you open it, what happens? It will get some bubbles, means the gas is releasing, right? The solute will be gas there and liquid will be the whole drinker. And coming to liquid, and here the solvent will be liquid and solute will be also liquid. Okay, so example we are taking here, alcohol in water. In the water if you add alcohol, then what happens? Both will be liquid. Alcohol will be a small amount, water will be more amount. So that is nothing but liquid, liquid. And coming to liquid solid. Liquid solid, all we can know, that is salt in water. So in the water if you add salt, salt is a solute and water is a liquid. Next, solid. Solid and gas. So here solid and gas is nothing but palladium. Okay, so palladium is a solid. Here we are taking a metal, and hydrogen. Hydrogen is a gas, H2 we are adding, and solid, solid liquid. So here solid liquid, what happens? Solid will be the silver and liquid will be the mercury. Here mercury is in liquid only, no, which is like a collide, it will act like. Okay, so coming to here, that one we can take. And also solid to solid, as you know, gold is a solid, silver is a solid, salt is a solid, sugar is also a solid. So these are nothing but examples. So here gas and solid, smoke in air I have spoken, you know, and also gas and liquid, water vapors in rain. Okay, so this is nothing but types of the solution based on physical states of solute and solvent. Now let us see each by one examples. So here, as we have discussed, gas in solid. So gas of solution of gas in gas. What we have spoken, example, air. Okay, and also oxygen, acetylene, welding apparatus. So here what happens? The oxygen is a gas and acetylene is also a gas. So when you have seen the welding people, when they strike that one, or when they stick the iron rods, so what happens? It gives fire, means it is giving fire, no, so it is giving the gas. And also at where it is going to the atmosphere. So that is one of the example, gas of the gas. And this is the gas in liquid here. Gas in liquid is nothing but what here? Oxygen in water and carbonated drinks. So here if you have been seeing drinks, see here how the gas is coming outside, and down part is all water. Okay, so this is nothing but gas in solid example, liquid example. And gas in solids is what here? gas in solids is nothing but here. See, if you take a metal, so here this is a palladium metal. So here H2 gas is absorbing here. See, in the palladium what happens? The H2 gas is going to absorb on the palladium molecules. So this is the gas in solids. Next one, liquid in gas. So liquid in gas, mist, fog, clouds. So see, clouds, okay. So when rain will come, automatically what happens? This in the atmosphere, it is the gas is present in the atmosphere, the liquid, the fog or mist, whatever it is there, it is releasing as a liquid, clouds. In the winter season, you can observe clearly. So in the cars, there will be water vapors on your cars, bikes, everything, right? This is about liquid in gas. Next, liquid in liquid. So in liquid, see here, when you add alcohol in water and also milk, milk is also liquid. In milk, we are having colloidal solution also, okay? So in milk also, if you add water, that is a liquid in liquid. And liquid in solid, cheese. See here, it is containing liquid and also it is a look like a solid. And butter also same like that. Mercury and silver is also same like that. Next one, solid in gas. Solid in gas is nothing but what here? Dust particles and smoke. So the smoke, whatever it is getting, it will combine with air, and in the air the dust particles act as a solid, and the gas will be, as we know, nitrogen, oxygen, remaining gases it contains. And next one, solid in liquid, sugar in water we can take, jellies we can take, paints, okay, all we are adding the in water. And next one, we can take solid in solid. Solid in solid is nothing but carbon in iron, steel, which indicates, okay, opals and pearls. So these are the pearls, these are the opals and metal alloys. So these all will contain the solid molecules only. Alloys is nothing but mixture of metals, okay? So these are types of the solids based on their physical state. Now let us discuss concentration expression. So then what is concentration? In the previous class we have seen what is the concentration solution. So here we are taking here 100 ml of water, okay. To this we are adding a some solute molecule, okay, more amount of solute we are adding. Let us take 30 grams. Then what is concentration? So coming to here, we should know number of moles. In the intermediate first year, we are going to learn the number of moles. What is the formula of number of moles? Number of moles is nothing but weight by gram molecular weight. So here for sugar, how many grams I have taken? 30 grams. Then what is gram molecular weight of the sugar? For example, if you have been taken glucose, so glucose formula is C6H12O6. So the overall atomic number, 16 to 12, 72 plus, 12 plus, 16 to 16, 96. So then how much you are getting? So 84 plus 96, 180. So you are getting overall 180. So if you 3 1s are 3 6 1 by 6, so 16 1 0 1 6 4 0 6 36 means what you are getting? Almost you are getting the value some 0.17 you got. So now why I have told you means, before going to concentration expression, we should know the number of moles, okay? So then here, as I have told you, concentration is nothing but what? More amount of solute is required to dissolve, okay? So here what happens in concentration? We are taking 100 ml, no? 100 ml of the solution we are taking. Means here it depends, the concentration depends upon the volume. It depends upon the volume and also depend upon the mass, weight, right? So then by this, what we can say, the concentration is nothing but what here? The concentration is nothing but number of moles of solute present per liter of the solution. So means what? Number of moles of, means what we can say, M by L. Number of moles of solute present, M by L. Moles indicates weight by gram molecular weight. We have found just now, that is 0.16. How many liter we are taking? Volume is expressed in liters. 100 ml we are taking. Okay, volume of the solution. So this is nothing but concentration of the solution. This what we are getting the value? 0.0016. We are going to get this value. Okay, so this is in concentration expression we are having different terms. Let us see that all terms. So there are five ways to express the concentration. So what are those? One is mass percent, molarity, molality, normality, mole fraction. So what is mass percent here? Weight of the solute and total weight of the solution. Okay, mass of the solute and total mass of the solution. Solution means what here? We should have solute plus solvent. Just now we have taken example here, 100 ml in 30 grams sugar. So 30 grams will be the mass of the solute. Mass of the solution how much? 30 plus 100. Okay, so this is about 30 by 130 we are going to get. So this is nothing but mass percentage. And also we are going to discuss here molarity, mole solute by liter solution. Molarity and molality is different. Here we are taking liter, and coming to molality we are taking only kg of this solvent. Here we are taking solution, and coming to here what we are taking? Here we are taking solvent. Okay, and normality, normality is nothing but what here? Gram equivalent weight of solute per liter solution. Mole fraction, mole fraction indicates moles of the solute per total moles of the solution. So these are the five terms we are going to discuss here. So here first of all let us see mass percentage. So what is mass percentage expression? So here mass percentage is nothing but, this is the expression, percent parts of solute per 100 grams of the solution. So here wrong it came. So this is a solute. So means what? Mass of A in solute by total mass of the solution into 100. So here what happens here? Solute is nothing but, we have taken a general example. Here the solute 30 grams of sugar will come, and total mass of the solution how much you are going to get? 30 plus 100, 130 you are going to get. So then 30 by 130 into 100 you are doing. So 10 will get cancelled. So with 13, if you do multiplication, what you are getting here? Some 0.2. So 13 2 is no 6, 4. So some 0.23 into 10. Then what happens? You are getting 23 by 100 into 10. You are going to get 2.3 is the percentage of this solute particle. Okay, so what is the formula? This is a expression of parts of the solute per 100 grams of 100 parts of the solution we are saying. So now let us see one more example here. What they have given? Determine the mass percentage of hexane in a solution containing 11 grams of butane in 100 grams of hexane. So here what? Containing 11 grams of butane. So here the butane they have given, hexane also as they have given. So what, how many grams is having for butane? 11 grams. For hexane how many grams? 110 grams. So what is the more value in that? Hexane is the more value. So by this what we can say? The hexane will be the solvent and butane will be the solute. So what is the formula? First mass of the solute, that is 11 grams of butane we have to write, divided by, and here solution we are saying no, 110 plus 11 we have to do. So 11 plus 110. Why? Because the solvent is here hexane. How we say it is a solvent? Because it is having more weight. Because of that reason we are saying it is a solvent. Okay, so into 100 we are going to do. Now if you do this one, what you are getting? 11 by 11. So means what? 121 into 100. 11 ones are 11. Okay. So 11 11 is 121. No? So 100 by 11. So you are going to get the value sum. What is the value we are going to get here? The value we are going to get here is 91% is the value. Why? Because here see, what you have told, mass of the component in solution divided by total mass of the solution. So mass of the component in solution is nothing but solute we are taking. So that contains what here? 110 grams solvent we are taking. This is not solution, this is solvent. Okay. So 110 divided by 11 plus 110 into 100, we are getting 91% as a value. Next, in this is the mass percentage we are calculating. Then coming to here, we can calculate percentage of weight, percentage of weight by volume, percentage of volume by volume. Now let us see one by one. Percentage of weight by weight. So here what we have to see, number of grams of the solute per 100 grams of the solution we have to take. Example, see, they have taken 10% W by W aqueous glycerin solution means what here? 10 grams of glycerin dissolved in 100 grams of the water. So remaining, so here 10 grams already glycerin, 90 grams will be water. And total will be how much? 100 grams of the solution we got. Observe clearly example what they have given. A 10% weight by weight aqueous glycerin solution means 10 grams of glycerin dissolved in sufficient water to make overall 100 grams of the solution. So means what here? 10 grams of glycerin is dissolved in 90 grams of water. If you add both of these, what you are getting? 100 grams. So overall you have got how much? 100 grams of the solution. Okay, so this is nothing but weight of the weight. Now then percentage of volume. So how you will calculate number of milliliters of solute per 100 milliliters of the solution. Means they have given ethanol solution. 100 ml ethanol plus 90 ml water. So then what you are getting here? 100 ml of the solution you are getting. Same like weight only. So here 10 ml of the ethanol and 90 ml of the water, if you take, they will become the 100 ml. So number of milliliters we are taking. So number of milliliters means here 10 ml of the ethanol we are going to take, we are dissolving in 90 ml of water. Okay, means 100 ml of the solution we are going to get. So this is nothing but percentage of volume by volume. Next, weight by volume. Weight by volume is nothing but what? Number of grams of solute per 100 ml of the solution. So here what they have given? 10% W by V aqueous NA solution means 10 grams of and salt is dissolved in 90 ml of water. Then how we are getting 100 ml of water? Means what here? 10 grams you are taking salt and 90 remaining 90 grams you are taking water. If you add this, what we are getting? Totally 100 ml of the solution. So this is nothing but weight by volume expression. Now volume by W. Volume by W is also same here. Here 10% aqueous glycerin means 10 ml of glycerin you are taking and sufficient water means 90 ml of water if you take, then you are going to get 100 grams. Okay. So here you have to see the expressions, the units you have to observe. And now here this one, see here parts per million or parts per billion we can say, whatever it is, same. So means what here? This is one of the way to express the concentration for dilute solution. So mainly because we can say, suppose any impurities is present in the water, that one we have to remove by using this formula. Okay. So then what we can say? PPM we can say. PPM means what here? Amount of the substance in a total amount of the solution. Parts per million means this is the million value. 1 milligram per kilogram. So means what you are getting 1 into 10 power 6. If suppose billion means what we can write 1 into 10 power 9. Okay. So for example, if you have been taken here, generally one solute glucose only you take here, it we are having the substance here, some 60 grams, and here in the down you are going to get here total number of parts of the component of the solution. So that one means what here, total they have given 6 grams, 6 parts, and here we are going to write into 10 power 6, and some total solution will be some 100 ml. So then you are going to get one value. Okay, this is about parts per million. See here, this is the formula: mass of A in solution by total mass of the solution, or mass of A in solution by total mass of solution into 10 power 9. Example they have given, see here, 3.6 milligrams of Na plus is detected in a 200. Okay, 200 gram sample of water from lake air. What is its concentration in ppm? So see here, 3.6 they have given of Na plus and 200 grams of water they have given. So by this what you will do, 200 plus 3.6 into 10 power 6, that one you have to do. So here what is the formula? Mass of component in solution by total mass of the solution into 10 power 6. Now let us see here, 3.6 milligrams. So this milligrams is changed into what? Grams. What is the value? Milligrams is changed into grams. Then 3.6 division by 1000, you are going to get 0.00. 4 zeros, you will get milligrams, no? 36. So this is divided by overall solution value, how much they have given? 200. By calculating that, how much you are getting? 18 ppm is the value you are going to get here. Now next one we are going to discuss here is molarity. What is the molarity? Number of moles of solute present per liter of the solution. Number of moles of solute is nothing but what here? So here number of moles of solute formula we know, weight by gram molecular weight. Solute, for example, you have been taking NaCl. NaCl atomic, Na's atomic weight is 23, chlorine atomic weight is 35.5. If you add this, what you are getting here? is the value you are going to get. So this is nothing but gram molecular weight. Then what is the weight here? 23. So for example, 23, if you have been written, if you cancel this, you are going to get one value, 1 by 2 into liter of the solution. For example, if you have been taken 1000, okay, so the 1000 will be the value here. So now let us see here, they have given example here. Molarity is nothing but given weight by gram molecular weight of the substance into 1 by volume of the solution in liters we are going to. Why? Because moles of solute formula is what? Weight by gram molecular weight. And here 1 into liter of the solution means volume of the solution, you have to take it in liter. Okay, for example here, if you, they have given 1 mole of NaCl, then number of moles formula what is here? Given weight by gram molecular weight. Then by calculating this, you are going to get the value 58.5. But here volume is a temperature dependent, molarity can change with temperature also. Okay, then what you are getting here, you are getting the, if 0.453, one more example we can see here, 0.435 grams of KMnO4 is dissolved in water to give 250 ml of the solution. What is the molarity of the KMnO4 they have asked? So first what you have to do means 0.435 grams you have to take in a, you have to weigh that compound in a analytical balance, and you have to add to the volumetric flask. After adding up to the mark, you have to add water and you have to shake it. So then they have given 0.435 grams, 1 mole KMnO4, how much we are getting here? Then 0.00275 grams. Why? Because here divided by The KMnO4 gram molecular weight is 158 grams. Okay, so by dividing these two, what we are getting here, mole weight by gram molecular weight. Now weight they have given. What is the gram molecular weight of KMnO4? 158. So then by doing this one, what we are getting? 0.00275 we are going to get here. Okay. Then coming to liter of the solution. How much liter we are taking? 250 ml we are dissolving this compound. Then what happens here? Then 0.00275 divided by 0.250 you are going to get. By calculating this, you are going to get the value. The molarity is expressed in the capital M. Okay, so see here, they have given in the question weight, we have to calculate the gram molecular weight. The gram molecular weight of KMnO4 is value this one. By doing this number of moles of solute, we are getting this value. And it is dissolved in enough water to give 250 ml. Means what here? We are weighing 0.435 grams of KMnO4. And it is adding in the volumetric flask. And this is a volumetric flask. And you add sufficient water up to the mark. So the remaining water we are going to calculate here. Okay, so in 250 ml we are calculating, no? So this is a 250 ml volumetric flask. We are adding substance. So this is the concentration we are getting here. Next one, molality. Molarity is different. Molality is different. So means molality is nothing but what here? Molality is nothing but here. Number of moles of solute dissolved per kg of this solvent. Means the moles of solute which dissolved in only 1000 grams of the kilograms of the solvent. That one we call it as what here? Molality. Okay, here both moles and mass do not change with temperature. Why? Because molality is not temperature dependent. Okay, like molarity. Now let us see example here. The example of this one is, a solution is made by dissolving 4.35 grams of glucose in 25 ml of water at 25 degrees centigrade. Calculate the molality of glucose in the solution. So by this, what they have given? They have given temperature. Okay, they have given grams and they have also given volume. Now the molecular weight, glucose is 180. So generally weight they have given 4.35, and here the gram molecular weight of glucose is what here? 180 grams. Okay, by calculating this. Now see here, generally number of moles of solute dissolved per kg of the solvent. Now here 4.35 grams of C6H5 means 1 mole, right? So then what you are getting here? 4.35 divided by 180.2 grams. After calculating this one, we are going to get, this is the value of the glucose mole value, that is 0.0241 grams. Now what they have given? 250 ml of water at 25 degrees centigrade they have given, to 25.0 ml. So water has density, you know, water will be having constant density. The density will be here 1. Okay, so the mass of the solvent, what we are writing? 25.0 into 1 gram per milliliter. By knowing the density, we can calculate the molality. The density of water they have not given, but the density of water is always 1 here. Okay, so then what we are getting here? At 25 degrees temperature only, at room temperature, the density of water will be 1. So then by multiplying this one, what we are getting here? The value will be 0.0 by dividing. Okay, so then you are going to get the value here, 0.0250 kilograms. Then you will be substituting in the molality formula, 0.0241 by 0.0250 kg. Then you are going to get the value, this one, that is 0.964. See here, once again I am saying, here in the question, the weight of the glucose they have given, we know that the gram molecular weight of glucose is 180, the number of moles of solute is value, this one, weight by gram molecular weight. Then after that, what they have given? Kg of this solvent we require. To know the kg of this solvent, they have given, the water contains 225 ml of water at 25 degree centigrade at room temperature. The density of water is 1 here. Okay, so by multiplying these two, what we are getting? 0.0250 kg. Then if you substitute the formula of the molality, the value we are going to get is 0.964. so this is the molality. Next one we are having normality. Normality is nothing but what? Number of gram equivalent weight of solute dissolved per solution. Here number of gram equivalent, we should know the equivalent weight of solute. So means what? Here we should know weight and gram equivalent weight we should know, then we can calculate the normality. It is denoted by capital N. So let us see what is equivalent weight. Equivalent weight is nothing but what? Number of parts by weight of the substance that will combine with one part by weight of replaceable H plus or OH minus ions. Means what? For example, if you take an acid, acid consists of what? H plus. Base consists of OH minus. In the given compound, we have to observe that H plus and OH minus ions. That is nothing but equivalent weight. Now let us see the, when the solute is an acid or base. For example, HCl means 1 H plus we are having. H2SO4 we are having, 2 H plus we are having. And coming to NaOH, we are having 1 OH minus. BOH twice, we are having 2 OH minus. So like that you have to see. Means what here? The equivalent weight. For example, here 1 only, now we are having 35.5 for chlorine atomic weight. So for example, let us see here KCl I have taken. K plus Cl minus. Then here how many positive and how many negative charges? Only 1. That is A will be 1. For calcium nitrate, see here, so positive ions is 2 plus, negative ion is 1 plus. So like that we have to calculate. So then equivalent weight, how we will get? Weight of the solute by equivalent weight of the solute. For example, HCl if you have been taken, the 1 will be the hydrogen and here chlorine will be the 35.5. Then you are getting 36.5. Okay, then what is the equivalent of solute here? H, how many H plus it is releasing? Only 1 H plus. So then you are going to get 36.5 by 5 by 1, you are going to get 36.46. so this is way to calculate the equivalent weight. Okay, then coming to normality, you have to calculate that one. Okay, now here mole fraction value. So this is the mole fraction. Mole fraction is nothing but what here? The ratio of the number of moles of the component to the total number of moles of all the components of the solution. Means moles of A by total mass of the solution and moles of B by total moles in the solution. That is nothing but mole fraction. Here always if you do addition, you are going to get equals to 1. So these are the concentration terms. So see here, what is mole fraction we are discussing? So the mole fraction is nothing but here, the ratio of the number of moles of the component to the total number of moles of all the component of the solution. As we know, moles of the solute, moles means what? Weight by gram molecular weight we know. Okay, so this is moles of A. Total moles in solution means what we have to do? A plus B. For example, I have taken 2 moles, that is 2 moles of A and 4 moles of B. These two values I have taken. So now I want to calculate for A. How you will calculate for A? I have given the value 2. Then 2 plus 4, how much you are going to get? 6. Means 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. What is the value? Some 0.3. 6 you are going to get the value. Okay, for B if you take 4 by 2 plus 4 and you are going to get 4 by 6. Then you are getting 2 by 3. Then you are getting some 0.663 you are going to get. Okay, so this is the way. If you add these two, XA plus XB is equals to 1. The mole fraction of always is equals to unity. Okay, so means what here? XA plus XB is equals to 1. If you know the value of XA, then xb is equals to 1 minus xa we can calculate. If you know the value of xb, then xa is equals to 1 minus xb we can write. In this way also we can calculate, in this way also we can calculate. So this is nothing but mole fraction. Okay, so these are the concentration terms of the solutions. By knowing these concentration terms of solution, we can easily do experiments in titrations, and we can easily calculate the mass percentage, normality, molarity, mole fraction. Okay, in the next class we can see the solubility topic. Thank you.